All right, today I'd like to talk to you about how many times that you can get away with breaking the no contact rule before it loses its effectiveness. Now, I'm kind of famous in this industry for the following graphic. Basically, it's an argument that every single time that you have to break the no contact rule or start it over from the beginning, it loses effectiveness the subsequent time. It loses its effectiveness the next time that you end up having to do it. But for this discussion, I really wanted to push the boundaries. I wanted to figure out the maximum amount of times that you could end up breaking the no contact rule without it actually losing its effectiveness. Now, there's a lot to consider here, but I always end up subscribing to the KISS method. Keep it super simple. And it seems to me that the answer to this question has been staring us right in the face. By looking at success stories who have gotten their exes back but broken the no contact rule in doing so, we can kind of figure out how many times that you are actually allowed to break the no contact rule without it losing its effectiveness. So here's what I'm going to do. Two things. I'm actually going to show you the actual interview in which I interviewed someone who broke the no contact rule but still got their ex back. Because you know there's just going to be this guy or girl watching this video and saying that I'm pulling these fake numbers out of a hat. And I want to quote the exact moment and the exact words in which they said that they broke the no contact rule. And then once we've done that, we can actually figure out how many times you're allowed to break the no contact rule. I spent over an hour combing through 26 total interviews, and my thinking was pretty simple. I'm going to look for any interview of a success story that mentioned breaking the no contact rule. Now, obviously, we've had a lot more than 26 success stories that came through our program that I've ended up interviewing. When I combed through all of them, a really good portion of them ended up living with their exes or working with their exes or having to do some form of limited no contact. And what I wanted was untainted data, something that only dealt with pure no contact rules. Now, out of the 26 different success story interviews that I audited, 10 of them admitted to breaking the no contact rule, which is an interesting number because that puts the number of individuals that failed to complete a no contact rule at 38%. This is vastly superior to the 80% of individuals that come through our program that don't get their exes back, that end up breaking the no contact rule. So already, people who succeed show that they fail the no contact rule a lot less. But those that do fail, well, those are the interesting ones. All right, let's start from the top. There are 10 different success stories that broke the no contact rule. We'll start with success story number one, which is Tita. Her quote exactly says, "For me, I did struggle between April and August. I did struggle, but something snapped. By the time I had failed, no contact, like the fifth time, I was just like, I need to give up because this is crazy." She failed the no contact rule 5 times. Success story number 2 ended up breaking the no contact rule 1 time. This is CJ. "Of course, I didn't have enough emotional control. At that point, I just responded like an idiot." Success story number 3 broke the no contact rule 2 times. This is Harley. She says, "Yeah, I broke the no contact rule twice, and it was like I went a week and then broke it, then I went another week and then broke it." Success story number 4 broke the no contact rule 1 time. This is Sarah. So I ask, "So you went to the no contact rule, you started over, did you make it through fully through the second go around?" She says, "Yeah." Success story number 5, broke the no contact rule 1 time. This is Joe. Now I say, "Okay, so what happens? I already know a little bit, spoiler, because she had this huge write-up on the Facebook group. So how long did you make it through no contact?" She says 41 days. I say, "Okay, that's still pretty a lot. So what caused you to break no contact early?" She says, "It was because, you know, how I told you that I started, did I tell you I started seeing a counselor?" Technically, that one is really close to completing the full 45 days, but she still broke it. Success story number 6 broke the no contact rule 4 times. Now, I say it did, yeah, so that's the other thing I'm noticing. It's people calling audibles mid-play, blah, blah, blah. Rachel says, "Well, yeah, I broke mine like 3 or 4 times." Success story number 7 broke the no contact rule 1 time. This is from Laura. "Yeah, so I'd say like if it happened in kind of the first month of me like starting the program, maybe even the first 2 months of sorting out, I'd probably been a mess about it. But I think it just got to a point where I was like, well, I don't need you. I was just looking first to sort things out. And if it wasn't going to be sorted out, then that's fine. And that does help." And I think that's the point that I got to in September. And that's why the second no contact rule works so well for me, because I wasn't bothered anymore. Success story number 8 says they broke the no contact rule 3 times. This is Becca. And so the first week, I wanted to say I started no contact at the beginning of April, the first week of April, and I broke no contact probably 2 or 3 times in the first week. So yeah. Success story number 9 broke the no contact rule 2 times. Yeah, and it gave me a really safe place to really vent, to go to focus and redirect. She's talking about our community, if you were interested. Especially because, you know, during the no contact, or the limited no contact with my first partner, I failed it like 2 in the first month, and I had to start for a 3rd time very seriously. And then finally, success story number 10 broke the no contact rule 1 time. This is Lauren. I ask, did you fail no contact at all when you tried it? Lauren says, yes, I failed it 3 days in. All right, so let's come up with the real failure numbers here. So 10 success stories, which I just read out to you and you probably found extremely boring, admitted that they broke the no contact rule. When you average it all together, that puts the average number right around 2.1 times. So this means that it's probably safe for you to break the no contact rule about 2 times before it starts losing an extreme amount of effectiveness. I want this number to scare you. Because the truth is, the number doesn't lie. And the one big thing about my approach to the ex-boyfriend recovery process is the emotional control that you're bringing to the table. The no contact rule, if anything else, is a perfect litmus test for how much emotional control that you have. And if you're consistently breaking the no contact rule, well, you're usually not having a high level of emotional control. It's definitely no mistake that the individuals who ended up getting their exes back ended up not only breaking the no contact rule a little amount of time. Remember, over 60% of people that I audited here did not break the no contact rule at all. But those that ended up breaking it didn't break it usually on average more than 2 times. Yes, there's a few outliers here and there, but those are what they are, outliers. So what's the big takeaway? Well, the big takeaway is emotional control is one of the most important things that you need if you are going through a breakup. So yeah, the next time that you're thinking of breaking the no contact rule, when you know you're not supposed to break it, I actually want you to come back to this video and watch the entire thing. Because just know that while it may not seem like such a big deal for you to break it and give in to those anxious tendencies, what could start off as a small thing becomes a very large thing. It doesn't take much to break a no contact rule 2 times, but that's all it really takes before it loses a lot of its effectiveness.